While biologists from around the world are fighting over a vaccine for a new virus, NASA experts are solving a no less ambitious task. Which region of Mars is suitable for landing the first crew in history to conquer the planet? Mankind must have options for salvation if some new terrifying threat arises hanging over the planet. The cost of error is too high. Human lives and expensive equipment are at stake. Where on Mars will man first set foot? And what qualified this region for such an honorable status? Choosing a place was extremely difficult. The main requirements for the area was the availability of an inexhaustible and easily accessible water source. The poles on Mars, with huge deposits of ice, would be ideal, if not for one but. In these regions, the first settlers could freeze to death. Since the temperature here can drop to minus 150 degrees Celsius, that's minus 238 Fahrenheit, and light doesn't reach here for several months out of the year. Therefore, such a polar landing was ruled out. So it was necessary to look for a place closer to the equator, where it's warmer and brighter. The equator itself didn't fit the requirements because there's too little ice, and it's difficult to access. It was necessary to find a site where there would be ice on the surface, no abnormal temperature changes, and exposure to light. NASA's planetary scientist and lead author of the study, Sylvain Picoux, and his team analyzed the images the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter, also known as the MRO, and Mars Odyssey Orbiter spacecraft had been collecting for 10 years. As a result, they found just the place. It turned out to be the Arcadia Planitia Plain, located in the northeastern part of the western hemisphere of Mars. What makes this area unique is that the water supply here is located just a few centimeters, about 1 inch, from the surface of the planet. So to extract it, it won't be necessary to transport complex and bulky equipment to Mars. An ordinary shovel will do. In addition, the surface water ice has another feature. It retains heat very well. So we can hope that this plain will have a mild climate for Mars. This area is clearly visible on the map of water ice on Mars. The blue color indicates the water sources closest to the surface. Red, the most distant. The black spots are sandy deserts where the spacecraft would risk getting stuck in fine dust. The area outlined in white is by far the most ideal candidate for the astronauts' landing. So, where could ice come from on Mars? According to one theory, it was formed as a result of ancient snowfall, followed by a dust storm that quickly covered the snow. This thin layer has helped preserve frozen water for billions of years. The ice is useful for scientific research. If it turns out to be a glacier, then its layers will tell us a lot about the planet's history. The cleaner and more accessible Martian water is, the easier it will be for robots and astronauts to use it to create fuel. The molecule H2O is composed of hydrogen and oxygen. Through electrolysis, we can divide water into hydrogen and oxygen. Then oxygen for breathing and hydrogen for rocket fuel appear. After all, once the astronauts land the rocket, they'll eventually need to return to Earth. Of course, to find a pond with liquid water near the landing site would be the ultimate dream. And such a pond may indeed exist on the Red Planet. In August 2018, scientists announced that a subglacial reservoir with a diameter of about 20 kilometers or 12 miles is hiding at the South Pole of Mars. Although the temperature in the lake is most likely in the negatives, researchers suggest that its water is liquid, just like on Earth. Impurities in the water and the pressure of the ice mass may reduce its freezing temperature. But the main catch is that the water is at a depth of about 1.5 kilometers or 0.9 miles. So, for production, we would need to deliver drilling rigs to Mars from Earth. For later stages of settling on Mars, this data will be useful. But the first astronauts on Mars are better off choosing a place with more accessible water resources. Scientists have already decided on a place for the first Mars landing. But what else do they need to prepare for the flight? The SpaceX Starship system is actively being built, which will deliver people and cargo to the Moon and other planets. Since 2002, the project has operated under various names. They've changed its concept, configuration, and materials as well. Yet, one thing has remained unchanged: the firm goal of achieving interplanetary travel. Starship is a two-stage reusable rocket. The second stage of Starship will be combined with a spacecraft, either a refueling ship or a refueling tanker. And the first stage, called Super Heavy, will have to return to the launch site. One version of the ship is about to embark on its first full-fledged orbital flight. Work on new spacesuits is also in full swing. SpaceX already knows what astronauts will be wearing on board Starship. For them, specialists have already developed stylish and lightweight suits with the help of a famous Hollywood designer for their appearance. The uniform is not intended for use in outer space, but inside the spacecraft, it will be comfortable. An Apple iPad will be mounted on the astronauts' thighs for quick access to spacecraft controls. NASA also is working on new spacesuits. In the fall of 2019, a presentation of new products took place. They designed one spacesuit for use onboard the ship and a second for spacewalks and research on the surface of the Moon and then Mars. The latter deserves special attention. The design of the XEMU spacesuit, or Exploration Extravehicular Mobility Unit, will have an open element layout system that will allow astronauts to independently modify their suit during the space program as new requirements emerge. For example, on Mars, it'll be possible to change the configuration of the spacesuit so that it matches the atmosphere of the red planet and seasonal temperature fluctuations. New suits will be able to withstand temperatures from minus 157 to plus 121 Celsius. That's minus 250 to plus 250 Fahrenheit. Work continues on an in-situ resource utilization system, or ESRU, which involves finding, extracting, and processing resources from the surface and from the depths of the planet and turning them into something useful: oxygen, electricity, building materials, and even rocket fuel. For such large-scale work, a large arsenal of robotic equipment will be needed. For this, the Helilani robot builder has already passed its first tests. Its role on Mars will be to build landing pads for spaceships, spaceports, and bases. There will also be someone to build houses for immigrants. NASA has developed the humanoid robot Valkyrie for working in difficult living conditions on Mars. 200 sensors installed throughout the robot's body, together with an optical LiDAR scanner and 28 mechanical joints, will allow it to navigate well in space to prepare building materials and construct various buildings. Perhaps in Valkyrie's company on Mars will be Justin, a bot with artificial intelligence, also created specifically to conquer the distant red planet. Engineers from the German agency DLR have been developing the Justin robot for almost 10 years. Now, this robot is able to handle various tools and weapons, take pictures, catch flying objects, and overcome obstacles. However, the most amazing thing is its ability to think. Thanks to its built-in artificial intelligence system, it's able to perform the most complex tasks without human control. Work is in full swing, but the issue of high radiation in space and the grueling isolation that awaits the first astronauts on the long journey to an uncharted planet still remains unresolved. After all, equipping colonists with the most advanced technological innovations is only half the battle. It's much more important to provide them with decent physiological and psychological conditions for life and work. So what do you think? Will there be a manned flight to Mars this century? Will we witness such a landmark event? Write an approximate date in the comments, and maybe your prediction will suddenly become prophetic. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. There are still a lot of interesting things ahead. Until next time.